Very good morning, everyone. And Mr. Noel is there from Victoria University. And very good morning to all the attendees who have joined. And I would request Emmanuel, Isa, Peter, you can even request your friends to join at that particular link. That will help to circulate. It's a simple link which has to be forwarded. If you have a WhatsApp group, kindly forward it for the same. Now is the time when we start today's webinar. And I welcome all the dignitaries whom we have, faculties, professionals, and my dear students who have joined today for the Career Opportunity and Pathway webinar series jointly organized by Victoria University, Uganda and Ganpati University, India. The Career Opportunities and Pathway webinar series is yet another innovative initiative which is taken by Victoria University, providing one of the best development opportunities, and this will even help students to develop professionals as well as executive people to explore in their respective skills as well as their abilities. Today we have eminent personalities who have joined today for the webinar. We have with us Honorable Pro Chancellor and Director General Dr. Mahendra Sharma sir from Ganpati University. We welcome you, sir. We also have with us Executive Dean Dr. Rajan Purohit. We welcome you, sir. We also have with us Executive Dean from Faculty of Computer Application Dr. Satyan Parikh. Thank you, sir, for joining us.
Hello. Yeah, thank you.
And as the expert for the day, we are having two experts, Professor Chetan Gandolia, sir, as well as Professor Hiral Patel from Ganpati University for today's webinar on career opportunities and pathways in basic Android application development. Moving ahead, I take this opportunity to invite Dr. Satyan Parikh, sir, Executive Dean of Faculty of Computer Application. Dr. Parikh is an academician in field of computer science, having more than 21 years of experience in higher education segment. This experience includes working as a leadership position at the institute university level and as a team member in university level committees, including Board of Governance, Academic Council, Finance Committees, Center of Advanced Research Committee, Advanced Committee for Startup Nodal Center, etc. Presently, he is engaged in development of university at different capacities, roles, and designation. As an executive dean, sir plays key responsibility including development and implementation of academic strategic planning. He is holding the deanship of Faculty of Computer Application, Ganpati University, for more than 4 terms till now, and has been able to establish and contribute to the ecosystem by having more than 14 UG, PG and integrated academic programs in fields of computer science and interdisciplinary subjects. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us today, and I would invite you to please address the audience.
Thank you, Remy. Good morning, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank Victoria University team Uganda and team Ganpati University for conducting such a wonderful webinar series on career opportunities and pathway. In this series today, we are going to explore the details of basic Android application development. I am sure that this session will help you to understand that how one can develop Android applications. Believe me, it is not a rocket science, and anyone can learn and develop the application using Android for the mobile. Just you need to do a commitment with yourself and engage yourself with Android. You would get the directions from our experts, and as you start your journey ahead, the team will help you. And they will help you to remove all the hurdles and prepare you in the expert in the field of mobile application development. Believe me, you can develop applications like YouTube, WhatsApp, Facebook Messenger, Instagram, TikTok, etc. with some practice while you continue with this program. Both of the experts are very good practitioners in the area of Android application development, and they are good teachers too. I am sure that their capability and your commitment make you an expert in the area of Android application development. Just you need to take a decision and start exploring the power of mobile applications. So let me hand over this program to the experts. Thank you everyone for listening me patiently. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I now hand it over the entire session to our expert. We, as an expert, we are having with us Dr. Hiral Patel. And to brief you about Dr. Hiral Patel, she has completed her PhD under Faculty of Computer Application with research title Prediction Model for Financial Products. Her research area includes machine learning. Being gold medalist, she has served over 10 years of experience in academics. She has achieved training certificate for Android developer fundamentals from Google in 2016, awarded as a young scientist in May 2017 by International Science Community Association in the 3rd International Young Scientist Congress. It's my pleasure to have you, ma'am. We also have with us Professor Chetan Gandolia from Ganpat University, and both Hiral Madam as well as Chetan Gandolia sir will be there with you today as well as tomorrow. He has more than 10 years of academic experience. To his credit, he's pursuing his PhD degree in the areas of machine learning, and he's a gold medalist in MCA. He has been actively involved and contributing continuously towards the development of various Android applications. He has been working with mobile application development, machine learning development, OOP, web application development. He has undergone Android developer fundamental training at Ganpat University as well as advanced Android development training at Google Signature Towers, Gurgaon, India. He has mentored and directed more than 200 students in Android projects and as a part of their curriculum. I welcome both of you, sir and madam, today. Over to you, please.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, all the participants. Today, this session, I'm going to discuss the career opportunities and pathways in basic Android application. So in this session, you will learn the summarized view of developing Android application. By this session, you will get the prompt idea, and maybe it's become a past, but by admitting this course, you will get more from scratch level of programming to the Android application development. In this session, I'm going to develop one basic application, and that gives you the insights how Android application will work. Okay, so by starting with the career opportunities and pathways in Android application. So first of all, let us discuss the global market share by the mobile OS. First of all, the mobile OS generally useful for the devices, smart devices like Android, iOS, Windows Phone, and other OS which we are using, that is Linux and Windows, for the computers. So these are the different OS, and this graph shows you how this different OS share the market, global market. And as you seen this graph, the 81% to 87% market hold by the Android from 2014 to 2013. So this gives you the insights for popularity of Android, and this is the more important for us to develop a career. So as we know, the Android is a mobile operating system. So by just using these Android devices, we can perform so many tasks. So, and it's easily available in market. That is the reason this is the more uses of Android application. So Maulik Bhai, please, I want to ask one question to the students. So please raise my poll one. Dear participants, I want to ask one question to you. Which are the mobile OS? And that is from the poll. Maulik Bhai, please. Yes, this is your one question. So I get the idea. Are you getting me or not? Which one is mobile operating system? Windows, Linux, or Android? Okay, so just give your answer by clicking the right option. Yes. So we get the idea. Are you getting me or not? Yes. Just select the option which is available on your screen as per your understanding. Yeah, you can share your views in chat also. Okay. Okay, so which one is right answer? Android. As we have already discussed, Android is one of the mobile OS. Now we started with the career opportunity. This previous slide shows you the demand, this market share by the Android. Now we are focusing on the career opportunity as Android developer. Whenever we are talking about world level pay scale statistic for Android level Android developer, then these are the statistics given by the world level statistics. So according to the experience level, the on an average salary will be defined over here, that is $76,000 to $114,000. But we have a people of Uganda, so let us talk about the Uganda pay scaling. So a person working in information technology in Uganda typically earns 26,60,000 Ugandan per month. But specifically, whenever we talking about the Android developer, the average salary in Uganda, that is 26 lakh Ugandan. But as we know, the experience and skill matters a lot. So according to this statistic given by the Salary Explorer, whenever the experience will be high, you will get the more wages. So for an example, if you have an experience of 5 to 10 years, then you will get the 36% higher salary than the below 5 years experience. So whenever we develop our skill, then you'll get the more salaries. So these are the chances for making a career in Android developer, as an Android developer. Now this is just some statistics which helpful you to just aware what is the demand for Android developer. Now let us start with the Android. Okay, this is the one look different versions for Android. But starting with the Android, I want to just give you the insight what is Android. So Android is nothing but one open source and Linux based operating system which is used for mobile devices such as your smartphones or tablets. So it's a one OS which we can use in our smartphones. So I want to give you some historical history of Android. This operating system first developed by the Android Inc., a software company, in 2003. After it was acquired by the Google in 2005. Then Google defined OHA, Open Hands Intelligences, a consortium of 84 firms to develop the mobile devices and its standards features. So as a part of this effort, they promote the different features. So by just activities of OHA, they define the mobile device capability and the Android features. And that is the main reason frequently we are getting new feature and updated version of Android. And here you can see by this image, these are the different versions of Android, from Android Alpha 1.0 to Pi and latest one, that is Q. Okay, so that is in refreshing mode. And by looking this one side, it is little bit difficult to remember all these numerical Android version. But Google give one more interesting Google your code name for remembering the versions of Android. For an example, just see here, for Android 1.0, the code name is Alpha, then Beta, then Cupcake, and so on up to the Pi. So what is that easily remember is, so Google gives the code name by alphabetical order and sugary name. That means the Swedish name, just seen by here, Alpha, then Beta, then C, Cupcakes, D for Donut, and up to the Pi. although that rules was broke up by this new version that is known as Android 10. But up to this, we can easily remember Android versions by the different sweet dishes name and in alphabetical order. So hope you will get my content. So I want to ask one more question. Maulik bhai, please raise poll number 2. Please participant, give your views regarding that poll. The poll is, which Android version series is sequentially proper in terms of release? So we have already discussed in this slide which one is properly in sequence. Just give your view in the form of release. That means first that is Kit Kat, then Jelly Bean, or first is Cupcake, then Jelly Bean. Which is the order? Just give your views by selecting the option.
Viral ma'am, can I just intervene for one second?
Yeah, ma'am.
Mr. Noel, if students are having some difficulty in joining yesterday's students, they can join through different email ID. They will be able to join. Bill sir, even if you could just spread across the WhatsApp group, if some of the students who were joined yesterday, if they are having any difficulty in joining by using different email ID, they can join today, sir.
Let me send the word. Let me liaise with Noel and see how to do it.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Hiral ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. So just give your please correct sequential option. Which one comes first and which comes later on? That we have already discussed in previous slide. Okay, as per your understanding, just select the sequence, which is the proper sequence in the terms of release. Which version release first, then after another one, and then goes on. Yes. So which one is first? Cupcake, then Jelly Bean, then Kit Kat, and then Oreo. It's follow the alphabetical order as well. So we can get the information by using this way. Now let us focus of why Android is so much popular. So this slide gives you the information which are the features that enhance the capability of Android. So the Android had so many features which gives the importance, just like the beautiful user interface, the connectivity, capability, messaging, multi-touch facility, multitasking, multi-language support, the utilities like Android Beam, Wi-Fi Direct we can use, any web browser we can configure. We can also configure the GPS, GCM, like features with the Android application that makes the Android applications very capable and enhance the applications uses by supporting open source. As we know, the Android is open source operating system, so anyone can use it, anyone can develop it, anyone can develop and put it in Play Store. So it's easily usable and developing by the developer. That's why the reason any developer can develop the Android application. So it will increase the market's need and also the integration with the another scriptings also. So the costing of Android is very low. We can have one account in Play Store, then any developer can put their application on the Play Store. The success ratio is also high and the environment that is provided by Android that is also good, and easily we can develop any application. So due to these all features, the Android is most usable language and any developer can develop it. So that is the reason. Now let us focus on the architectural view, because today in this session we are going to develop an application. This is one insight for the architectural view of Android, so you can get idea how the Android application works. In architecture, there are 4 layers with 5 different components. the lowermost layer, that is Linux kernel. As we know the capability of Linux kernel, so in Android all the drivers that are written in on the Linux kernel, and the uppermost layer, that is application, whatever application in our device that is working on this layer. So in between we have libraries and application framework. So what is the responsibility of libraries? So libraries provides the inbuilt facilities which is supported by Android, just as media support, free type, WebKit support, multi-language support, security support, that all predefined libraries are available. Surface manager, the location related, the graphical related library. So we can utilize it in our application. Now the framework. The application framework layer provides the different types of manager which controls the different aspects of Android application components. For an example, let us consider the activity manager. So what is the task of activity manager? So activity manager manages and controls all the aspects of activity. We'll learn what is activity, but just that is one example how the manager will work. So manager is responsible for to manage the different application based and OS based issues and control these all by it. The last component, that is Android runtime. Android runtime had a core libraries and virtual machine which responsible to provide virtual runtime machine. It's also responsible for to generate the executable code so the application can easily run. So this is one insight how the application works. So we'll get the how we can manage our application in our mobile at the time of development. So this is the some shorting view. These are the components, these are the layering which gives the specific responsible task to the Android application. Now after this, just which type of application we can develop by the Android. Okay, so you all using your smart devices, you all are using and you have different types of application. Still a market need more and more. So we can develop these type of different application, like we can develop our own player, we can develop our own social media based application, that is chat based, the video based, media, multimedia based, lifestyle based, any game-based application. So these are the different categories available for to developing the application. So this gives you among this gives you the insight which type of application we can build with the Android. Up to this is the some short of theory. Now we are focusing on the actual development. So whenever we are going to develop any application, we require some of the component. So let us talk about Android application components. Okay, so whenever you are using any of Android application that made up with these four component, that may be one is absent or that may be one only there. Okay, so that is depends on the need of your application. So there are four types of different components available in Android. The first one, that is activity. What is activity? So activity, that is the UI and it's handle the user interaction. And among all components, only the activity has the user interface. So I'm repeating, activity is also one of the Android application component, but only that component had user interface. So what it means, whenever we are using our application, for an example, WhatsApp, whatever we are interacting, that is a part of activity because remaining three doesn't provide the user interface. Now, second part, that is the services. So what is services? Services is responsible for handling the background processes. Whatever background process is running for to make a application running, that is done by the services. For an example, if you have set your alarm, then your application will be closed. But when your time set and that comes, then automatically alarm ringing. So that is the background task for mapping the time. So that type of task done by the services, and that type of feature we can develop by the services. Next, that is the broadcast receiver. So what is the role of broadcast receiver? So whatever communication if we want to make up with the OS and application, that is done by the broadcast receiver. For an example, notification. For any, if we want to generate any issues for one application, then all application get the information, that is message passing between OS and application. That is done by the broadcast receiver. The next, that is content provider. Content provider provides the facility to manage the data and database management related issues that can be managed by the content provider. So any application we can develop by using these four components. That is no any compulsion rule. We must have to use four. But as per our need, as per our aim and objective, we can utilize the component. One more consideration, whenever we are using any component, that must be registered into the Android manifest, that means your configuration file, that is done by automatically. So this is the rule, whenever we are adding any component, that also that automatically registered in the Android manifest file. So clear, these are the four components. Whenever we are going to develop any application, we have to use as per our need. Okay, so these are the four components. Now I also want to ask one question by this slide. So Maulik bhai, please generate one poll for, so I'll get the idea they are getting or not. So which one is open source operating system? Yes, give your views. We have already discussed which one is open source operating system. These all are the mobile operating system. Just select your views. Which one is open source? And as you all know, just select the option from your screen. Okay, which one is open source? Android. But obvious, iPhone and Windows phone, that is the platform dependent operating system. Android is open source. Okay, so anyone can develop and anyone can use. Okay, now in this session we are focusing on how to develop basic Android application. So here I am demonstrating one application. I'll implement this and I will run in my phone, so you'll get the idea how you can build any application. Don't bothering about it you have programming knowledge or not. By opting this course, you can learn from the scratch of programming to developing Android application. But in this session, I am demonstrating one application development, so you'll get the idea what is the importance and how we can develop the Android application. So just try with me and don't gather any bothering. You don't know these. Just try to focus on it, so you'll get idea how we can implement the Android application. So let us consider this example. We want to develop this calculator based application. So I want to make my own application which has like this application. This is the UI, user interface I want, that has two boxes for entering the values from the user, and these are the four buttons which perform the event handling according to the task that just defined by this button. We are generating our answer. Okay, so for this we have to follow these four tasks. So let us start with first, that is create the necessary widgets. Widgets, that is mean control or user interface. So let us consider this is my Android Studio. How to install Android Studio and how to configure your virtual machine, that I have already shared in prerequisites. So just see, this is the screen for developing the Android application. Just see here, whenever we are creating any project of Android, the activity, the default activity is there. Why default activity is there? As I have already mentioned, the activity is only the component that has the user interface. So whenever we are developing any application, we must have to provide the user interface, then and then we can do something. So default activity is there first. So the activity has two different pages. One is for Java, one is for XML. So what is the task of XML file and what is the task of Java? The XML file is responsible for to define the designing view. Just see here, whatever you are designing here, that component placed over here. So you can design your view, your layout using XML. And the XML file in Android, that is known as layout file. So every activity had two file, one is XML, one is Java. The XML file is known as layout. Layout, that means your user interface designing, your widgets which you have put it on in your application. The second one, that is your Java, where you have put it your code to perform some of the task. Okay, up to this clear? Now Maulik bhai, just raise one poll number 4 so we can get idea they are getting me or not. Yes, Maulik bhai, please share one poll. Yes, which component of Android application has user interface? We have already discussed 2 or 3 times. Which component of Android application has user interface? Activity, services, or content providers? Which one is right? Just select your options, so we'll get the idea. Yes. And if you have doubt, you can write in chat box so we can solve your doubts. Yes. And we are demonstrating one application. Don't bothering, you don't know this. You will learn everything whenever you are joining this course. Okay, which one is right answer? Activity. As we know, in Android, only the activity had a user interface. So now our activity is ready. Now what is the first task we have to do? We have to design. That required 2 text box for entering the values from the user for buttons to performing the basic task, and 1 text view for display the answer. Okay, so this is the layout. What is layout? For defining or arrangement of the component. Okay, whenever we are using linear, that means the straightforward. So if you want to make straightforward horizontally, then you have to provide orientation property horizontally. If you want to put your control vertically, then you have to provide the vertical. Okay, so linear layout, how to arrange your component, whatever widgets you are going to use within your layout, that you have to define by the orientation property, vertical or horizontal. Okay, so now let us start with what we need. First, we need 2 text box. So whenever we want to get input from the users, then what we have to use in Android, that is edit text. So here edit text is there. We can drag and drop, but you will not get the idea how that is work. So for the width, we are using mesh parent, and for the height, we are using wrap content. Why mesh parent? Mesh parent, whenever we are using, then it's become the size, how it will occupy our portion of screen. Okay, just see here, if I am writing the hint, that means what I want to display in text box. Just I want enter number 1. Just see here. Okay, so just see here, that is enter number 1, but your size, that is up to the entire screen occupied by that. Again, I am changing the size of font by using the property text size. Here, whenever we are defining the size, we must have to provide the measurement unit in the form of pixels or your IP or PX or density pixel. Okay, so if I want to make pixel size 30, then I have to use 30 pixel. If I want to make many more large, then 40 pixel. So automatically it will change the size of the font. Just see here. Okay, so it will define the text size. Then if I want to change the color of the text, then we can use the property text color. Okay, so here these are the predefined color. If you want to prepare, then we can, but here for demonstrating, if we are using primary. Okay, so that is become, just see, the color will be changed whenever we are running. It will be the like this color. Okay, so here we are setting text size for increasing the font size, text color for defining the color. Now, one most important property, whenever we are defining any control, we must have to give the unique identification for that control. Because as we know, the XML is different, the Java is different. So how that component will be integrated, that is done by this ID. So for any component, if we want to use in this Java at a runtime, then we must have to give the unique identification by defining the ID. So here my ID, that is edit text. So this is the text number one. Any variable name you can give, okay? But like this, you cannot give in Android. Just concentrate here. Like this, we cannot write anything. For that, we have to start with @ plus ID. Then we can write our variable T. Clear? If you are directly write, then it will not permitted by the your editor. Why? Because XML is also case sensitive. Your Java is also case sensitive. And whatever we are writing in Android, that is in the form of resource. For an example, if we have an image, then in Android, it is considered as a resource. If we are talking about the font size, then also it is considered as a resource. Let us talk about the string, the ID name. That is also the resource of the Android. So whatever we are manipulating in Android, that is in the form of resource. That's why @ is everywhere. Whenever we are manipulating the resource in Android, we must have to use @ whenever we are manipulating in XML file. Clear? So you will learn in detail, but today just for the demonstrating, this is the way we are dealing with. Okay, so my one edit text is prepared. Now I want to prepare another one. So how? Just repeating this one, so we'll get the idea. How to create one more? Because we want to get value two values from the user. So from the bit, we are using match parent. This is already available values we are utilizing. Then wrap content. As per the content, the height will be defined. Okay, then another, we are providing hint. Why hint? If we are providing text, then we have to erase this. If hint, then that is the disabled text. When we are focusing on that text, it erased automatically. So here we are providing hint as enter number 2. Okay, now what we can define over here? Text size for unique look and feel. Here again, we are defining same size of text, 45. Just remember, whenever we are dealing with Android, just provide the measurement unit, DP or pixel. Okay. Again, I want to define the color of text, then text color. These are the predefined color. We can develop our own color in the resources, but for the demonstration, we are using the inbuilt color. Okay. So that is the design. Okay, and the most important property I have to set over here, that is ID, because we have to manipulate the values of this both text in the Java. So here again, I have to define ID. So @ID and then text number 2. Again, Why this at the rate color that doesn't have plus, but at the rate plus ID that has plus? So whenever we are manipulating the resource, the color we are adding, okay, by preparing the another file. But whenever the IDs we are using, that may be the possible whenever we are drag and drop, automatically IDs will be assigned. So if we are giving our own ID to it, then it gives the indication, please add this one more ID for this added text. One more important thing about ID, whenever we are defined IDs of any component in activity that is visible in entire application. That means if we are taking one more activity, then again that ID is visible to that one also. So you must have to take care whenever you are defining the IDs, and you must have to take care to remember that IDs by utilizing at the runtime. Okay, so ID is what? Just the unique identification. So now my both text box are ready. Now the next what I need, that is the button. Okay, so Android we have a button tag, so we are using button again, wrap contained and wrap contained. Here we are defining the text. Text, that means whatever you need to show in your button. So I want to show the plus sign, so I can get the information. This is the button that perform the summation. Okay, then next I want to provide the text size. So text size, that is again as per your need you can define. If I am providing this one, this is similar, and I'm just see here, your button is also ready. Okay, so this is the orientation vertical. So we are getting all the component vertically automatically. Just see here, if we are adding the padding, this is one of the most property we can use. If we are using padding as a 20 pixel, just see here, whenever your component are there, automatically it will just put the spaces. Okay, so this is my button I have created. I want this type of four button. Just see here, four button I have to create. XML is also the case sensitive, so you must have to check the letter or whatever word starting with. Just see here, if I am starting with button from the B, so I am not getting, but if I am starting with capital B, automatically I am getting my button. Okay, then after what I have to set, this is my repetition of creating button, I have to set the text. Okay, here we are creating the button for minus, then we are creating the another text size. So whatever size you have defined, that's follow uniquely, so we'll get the look and feel. Okay, so just see here, one more button is added. Okay, now again I want more two button, so again wrap contained. Just see here, what is the difference between wrap contained and match parent. Okay, just see here, if I am using match parent, okay, your button looks like this. Okay, if I am using wrap contained, so it will wrap or it will take the size of button as per the content. Okay, automatically if your contents are high, then automatically it will fit up. Okay, so if you are using match content, then what happened, this will occupy the entire screen horizontally or vertically as per your height and width. Again I want to define my text for this button, that is multiplication, and then the text size. Okay, the size again similar pixel. Okay, you can drag and drop, but for just get the information which property you can utilize, that's why I'm using the XML. Just see here. Okay, three buttons are ready, and four I'm putting here as like this. Okay, just the division. One more information I want to say, I'm not adding here a ID, because I don't want to any binding at a runtime for this button. That's why. And if you want, then you must have to give the ID. So again, if you want to give the ID, then at the rate ID button, Sam. Okay, that must be unique for entire application. As I have already shared, these IDs are visible to entire application. So if you have defined that BTN MIN ID in this activity, that is visible by any of activity which you have added in an application. So again, I am adding one more ID for this button. So that ID is already available. That is for the sum, minus, and this is for the multiplication. So by giving this name, I can easily remember whatever name I have given. Okay, this is for the multiplication. So BTN MIN. So these IDs are, we can use at runtime. Here we are adding the ID. Yes, and that is BTN division. Okay, so our UI is ready. Just see here, as per the this loop, are two edit text, four different buttons, and the last, that is the answer. So just see here, we have already defined one edit text, that is enter number one, enter number two. Just see here the effect of padding. We have the padding, that is the component in between spaces are automatically added. Then these are the four buttons, and here we want to define our answer. So in Android, for fetching the values from the user, we have to use control edit text. Again, I'm repeating.
Well, ma'am.
Yes.
Sorry to disturb you. Yes. Can we ask the student that they are understanding this practical or not?
Are you getting or not? If you have any trouble, just write on chat box. Are you getting? Or if you have any difficulty, just ask.
I think we can assure them that in case of anything, a video link is going to be provided and they should be able to follow accordingly. Yeah, but just keep assuring them that all is well. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Chetan, sir.
Yeah, we may proceed. We may proceed.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. So these are the designing component. So we have already prepared how the designing portion of Android. Just see here, we have defined the two edit text, four buttons, and text view. Okay. Just I'm repeating how to define it. We have first edit text. Okay. For edit text, for entering the values from the user. So we have just set the different properties of edit text, that is text size and color. Okay. Again, don't bothering about these all things. You will learn properly. But for this demonstration, just we are using this as a color, how we can utilize. Okay. So here we have edit text one for entering the number one. We have edit text two for entering the number two. And we have defined only the three properties, text size, color, and ID. We can utilize more, but here for our purpose, we are defining this only. We have four buttons, button one for summation, button two for minus, button three for multiplication, button four for division. Okay. And this last one, that is the text view for displaying our answer. So again, for entering the values from the user, we are using edit text, and for display the values to the user, we are using text view. So again, if we are using text view, then we have to define the ID, that is TXT answer. So whatever we are using at runtime, so we have to bind this ID. Okay. So for this answer, we have given the ID text answer. We can also set the size of the text size of the text view, so we can easily visible. So 45 pixel. We can also set the color of our answer, that is our text view, that is color, anything. Okay. So this is our designing. Okay. How we can utilize it. So we have this one. Again, whenever we are inputting from the user, so what we have to do, we have to define the input type. Because if we are not providing here an input, then what happened at the time of submission? We are not getting the proper answer, or that may be the possibility the exception will occur. Okay. So before moving forward, Maulik bhai, just generate my next poll so I can get the idea they are getting me or not. Maulik bhai, just generate the next poll so we are getting the idea they are getting me or not. That is poll number 5.
Maulik bhai, please generate poll number 5.
Poll. So we can get the idea they are getting the practical stuff or not. Poll number 5, I think.
I'll just cross check, ma'am. You can continue. I'll cross check.
Yeah, okay. So which you can get this designing over here, okay? We are utilizing the different properties. So we are getting this look and feel. So after this designing, what we have to do? We have to perform our action. Just see here, by clicking on plus, what we need? The summation of this both number. By clicking on minus, we need the answer, that is the minus of that answer. So now what we have to do? We have to perform the event handling. But before that, how we can bind this XML component, whatever button we are using, whatever edit text we are using. Okay, this is the poll. Please, student, gives your answer. Please, participants, which property of widgets is used to define unique identifier? Because this is the most important in Android. We must have to take care for it. Which property of widgets is used to define unique identifier of component? Just select your option. Width, ID or name. Which you have to define? Which property is used to define unique identifier? Just select your option as per your understanding.
Maulik bhai, let us know when you get all the answers.
33%, madam, answer.
Okay. Just close the poll. Okay. Which one is right answer? The ID. As I have already shared the views about ID, whenever you are declaring ID, that is unique identifier for entire application. So we must have to define the ID. Okay. Now just say here, we have already defined our user interface. Now for using this, we must have to perform the binding task. Now the next step, the second step of our application development, that is IDs binding for design and coding synchronization of object. So what does that mean? Okay, just here, if you have two layout file, that means XML file, then how you can get idea which one is your Java file? So whenever you are opening your main activity.java, under the on create, you have this name of your XML. Just see. R.layout, these are the conventions for utilizing the resource. Don't bothering about it. You will learn properly by opening this course. Don't get bothering. This is just a demonstration. So what is this? Whenever we are going on main activity, under the on create, we have one method set content view. That method had one name, one resource name, the layout name, which defines which layout file for this activity. Okay, so for main activity.java, we have activity underscore main. Just see here, no need of extension. So this just gives you the information which is layout file for which Java file. Okay, up to this clear. Now what we want to do, we want to utilize this all control, that is we want to use whatever information you user entered in edit text, that we have to utilize over here. So before doing anything, the first process in Android, whatever object you have created over here, first you have to declare in your activity. So in runtime, I need the values from the user in edit text 1 and 2. So first of all, I have to declare two edit text. Just see here. So here that classes are available. Just I have two edit text. So I have defining two objects. Clear? Whatever just widgets you have, that classes are available in Java. So the first, whatever you want to utilize at runtime, that object you must have to create over here. Okay, so I have two edit text, then I have created two different edit text object. Now how this ed1 reflect the value of this edit text? Okay, this is my one edit text. So for that, in Android, in onCreate is predefined lifecycle method that you will learn, but this is the method always available, and whenever an activity launch, that method automatically initialize all the component. Initialize, that means the binding of the object. So here we have ed1 in our Java file, and we have text n1, that is our id of edit text 1 in XML. So how we can bind it? So here we have to define our code. ed1 is equals to one method is there, find view by id, and here we are utilizing the resource. So in Java, first is r, then dot id, and that dot whatever name you have given, that is text n1, and the semicolon. Again, I am repeating, we have here text number one in as a name of or id of our edit text in layout file. In Java we have ed1, okay, that is object of edit text. Now how we can synchronize this object? So in onCreate, that is the method automatically called by activity manager whenever activity in pop. So it automatically register whatever component you have defined in this method. So here we have ed1, we are giving the reference through the find view by id method. So find view by id method gives the reference of this txt1, that is our XML component. We get the IDs of this by using r.id. R is a registry in Android that is available in entire application. Whatever IDs you are defining, whatever component, whatever resources you are defining, that unique entry managed by the r.java file. This is also one of the Java file. Okay, so everything, as I have just told you, everything in Android that is in the form of resources. So r.java manages all the resources. So here id is one of the resource. I have given the name text number one. Here I want to utilize it. So find view by id, here I want to give the id reference. So by r.id class is already available in r.java. We don't have to create anything. This automatically managed by Android. We don't have to bother about this all thing, how r.id will get. So whenever you are assigning id here, that automatically registered in your r.java. Just you have to utilize like this r.id.text1. So whatever you are inputting in text number one, that automatically referenced by the ed1. Clear? This is the id synchronization. For that we have to use find view by id. We have another one, that is what, which another edit text we have, which value also we need at runtime. So again, find view by id. Yes, again r.id. What is the name of another text edit text? That is text2. Again, if you are giving here a wrong id reference, then runtime you will get the error. Okay, just see here, or you are getting the misinterpreted result. So just see here, my number one had the id text number one, my another had a text number two. Now easily ed1 referenced by text number one, ed2 that is referenced by text number two. Here I don't want to use any of stuff regarding button. मुझे runtime I don't want to create any button object. Okay. So what this mean? ED1 now it becomes the text1. ED2 that is text2. Okay. So whenever I am running this, whatever value I am entering in text1 number 1, automatically in Java it referred by the ED1. Okay. This is the main objective of find view by ID. Okay, up to this clear? Okay, so Maulik bhai, again create one next poll, so I'll get the idea they are getting or not. Generate next poll. Yes, which method is used to bind XML widgets to Java object? Because all you know, these both are different file. So which method you can use? Just share your answer. Which method you can use? Just give your answer, find view by ID or bind ID. Which method we can utilize? For binding the objects. Which method? Just share your answer. Yes, Maulik bhai, please close the poll. Which one is right answer? Whenever we want to bind or object synchronize, we must have to use find view by ID. And we take care, this Java is also case sensitive, your XML file is also case sensitive, okay? So the method naming convention you must have to take care, okay? So what is the second? That is ID binding, design and coding synchronization. So design, that is your XML, and coding, that is your Java. So we have done our bindings. Now the third portion is what? We have to generate the event handling. Okay, so what is event handling? If I'm clicking on button plus, then whatever value I have put it in text1 and edit text2, that will be sum and display in this answer. Okay, so just see here my text is answer. Anything you can put here, this is the answer. So you'll get the idea. Okay, so for that, what we have to do, we have to perform the event handling. Now in Android there are the three ways to perform the event handling, but here we are using only the XML binding for event handling. Okay, so whenever you want to perform XML binding for event handling, here we have one property on click. Okay, just on click property and give your method name. So here I want to call sum method. So the variable name, this is not compulsory call sum, any of name you have to give, but you must have to remember whatever name in which case you have defined. It's a case sensitive. So whatever variable name you can give, but you must have to remember that name. So here in all click, what I have defined, call sum. Now whenever you are define alt enter, you will get the idea which method alt space. Just see here, yes, just you get the idea which method you want to define over here. So this is the method called sum. Okay, now how we can develop this call sum? So after on create, just create call sum. Okay, so what is this especially the public method that is in Java, that is return nothing, public void, the name of method that is call sum, S is capital. And whenever we are defining the method, we must have to give the argument as a view. Just see here. Here, alt enter, so automatically it will enter the code. Okay, so what it will do, it will importing the view that is available already in Android. Getting my point or not? Here we have called sum, that is the simple variable name of the method, and here we have already implemented the public void call sum that must had one view argument. Okay, so now no need to implement any of listener. Whenever I'm clicking on this button, automatically it will call this method. Okay, so in this method, what we have to do, we have to perform the summation task. So how we can perform the summation? So we have to fetch value 1, value 2. Again, how we can create the method? In this, we have to define onClick. In onClick, just a name of method by just putting alter enter or just going to the main activity, you are getting this method by developing this public void call sum. But the specific intention that you must have to pass the view in argument. Here you don't have to give any type of any type of symbol over here, just any then only the name. Just see here, this is the name. Now I want to get the values and then I have to make a summation. So these both are integer, that is value 1 and 2. So integer a, b, these are the variable we can perform the manipulation. So what is a, b and answer? A, b and answer are the type of variable integer, so we can manipulate the information. So just see here. So we are fetching the value from the edit text and we are storing in A. So how we can fetch the value? So ed1 is available. So now in Java, we are referring edit text 1 as ed1. So ed1 dot get text is already available method. So whatever user enter, we are getting into the get text. And by performing to string, we are getting into the string. But whenever we are performing manipulation, we must have to convert string into the integer. So how we can just convert this one? So just before that, we have to just pass our integer dot parse integer is there, which require the string. That string we can provide by the edf ed1.getText.toString. So what ed1 written, that always the text we are converting into the string. Okay, if that is object, then automatically it will convert into the string. So we need the integer because we want to perform the mathematical operations. So integer.parseInt method is there, which require the string, whatever string we are defining, that is converted into the integer. Okay, this is for the one. Now we want another number. So again, we are defining integer conversion. So integer.parseInteger. Here, where from where we are getting the text? ed2 dot get text, okay, then dot to string. Okay, hope you are getting me. Because why this conversions is required? Because we are fetching the text and we want to perform mathematics any computations. So for performing this, we require the integer value. Okay, now we can easily write this answer is equals to a plus b. Okay, now that is the a, that is whatever value we have entered in edit text 1, b, that is any value we have entered in edit text 2. Okay, now I want to display my answer in this one. Okay, so which one? The display text, display control we have defined, that is text view. So whatever answer we want to display in the which one? Text view. So again, if we want to use runtime, then what I have to do? I have to create the object of text view. But see here, I don't have the object of text view. So I can't use that one. So before using text view, I must require the object of text view. So I'm creating text view, that is TV text view. before using I must have to binding it with XML. So TV is equals to find view by ID. This is the recalling why it requires. Now you are getting ID, whatever the ID of text view. Just see here, what is the ID? TXT answer. So you must have to give the TXT answer. Then and only then this text view object you can bind from the Java. So whenever you are binding this TV text, then automatically that gives the values to the text view. Getting me? Okay, why this binding task and how we can integrate the components. So here directly we can write TV dot set text is one of the function in Android for setting the text in any of the gates. So how we can set the value? So the answer is now plus what you have to write here, answer the variable name. So the text will be concatenated by the value of answer. Okay, so this is the view. Just before just we are running this, so you will get the idea, you can get the better idea. So up to this, sir, please raise one more poll. Yes, just give your answer so we can get the idea. In layout file, which property of button we get used to define the method, because we want to perform the event handling. So which method we are using in XML?
Where is the poll?
Poll is visible. Hope you are getting the poll.
Yes, it's visible.
It's okay. Visible. So just give your answer in which layout file, which property you can use for the button for define the method. Okay, up to this, our application is in running mode, so you'll get better idea. And directly I am running this application in my mobile by direct running here. So you'll get the idea. Just share your answer, whatever you have understand. For calling the method, which property we have defined in XML file? Which method we have, which property we have utilized?
Like by what is the status of poll?
Sir, 44%.
Okay.
Okay. Close the poll. Okay.
There is one more announcement.
With your
permission, if I can.
Sure.
Thank you. Professor Bill, even if students want to enter and join right now also using the same mail ID which they have, they can do it now. I would request if you could forward the same message to Christine ma'am as well. Thank you.
That's all right. Actually, we're doing it. We're working on it with Noel, and I'm sure all should be well. As you can see, the numbers are still increasing.
Yes, I just saw, okay, because he is able to join right now. That means he's been able to access it with the same mail address.
So, yeah, they are still able to. And actually, we're assuring them that the video is going to be provided, whatever they have missed.
Yes.
They are going to play catch up, and actually in due course we're going to provide them with the outlines. Whoever may wish to enroll for any of these courses in detail, we shall be giving them the details as we move forward.
Thank you, ma'am.
So up to this, whatever we have prepared, we are running, and it will show you in this mobile. We can run our application in emulator, but this demonstration gives you the insight. We can directly develop our application and we can directly run in our phone. So using this Wiser software, you'll get entire application in my phone by running this. Just it gives the install. Okay, just see here, that prepared application you will see here. Okay, this is our designing and what we have got here. So I'm entering the value. Just see here the keyboard. We have the character also, so we can change it. But if this is the difference, okay, and we have prepared this one. 34 plus 56, we get our answer here. Now we have to manipulate. We need only the numbers whenever we are manipulating the number only. So as you have seen, whenever you are calling, the keyboard is only of the numbers. Okay, so that also we can provide here by single property setting. If we are setting here a input type equals to number, then we are getting the only the keyboard with the numbers. So we can only enter the numbers. So automatically the number validations is supported. Just see here, it display only the number. So again, whenever I'm running, so we are getting only the number. Okay, so up to this, what we have done, we have created the UI, then we have binding that component, then we have calling the method by using this property.
Someone is raising their arm, probably yeah. Asking something, I don't know.
Chetan sir, who have problem?
Molek bhai, can you please allow to Isa Mohammed?
Yes, sir. Yes, unmute.
Hello, Isha. Can you please unmute your mic and tell me the question you have? Hello, Isha, are you there?
Yes.
Yeah. What is your problem? What is your question?
I want to know the calling, how they call from the activity name to the Java.
Yeah. Again, I'm repeating by performing the minus operation, so you'll get the idea. Okay. Repeating how to call the method. Okay. Up to this, we have performed only the one operation by this call sim. So again, just see here, we have remain three buttons. So again, we are calling this method. So just by using on click property, here we are using XML method calling. So we have to utilize this method on click. Here we have to define the name of method which we want to implement over here in main activity.java. So we are defining here, call any name you can give, the variable rules will be applied. So call minus, okay, my method name is call minus. No any other sign you have to put over here. This red sign comes up to this if you have not specified any method with this name. So if you want to build this method by this way, by implementing the method, you can, the shortcut way, just press control space, control alt enter. Yes, by pressing alt enter on text, you are getting create call new method, whatever name in main activity. So I'm clicking on this. So just see here, that similar method I'll get automatically in my main activity.java. So if you are not getting this one, so you have to develop that previously I have developed over here. But what you have to take, you must have to take care, that is view argument you have to pass. Clear? Again, I am repeating how to create a method. So this is for minus. Now again, I am creating method for the multiplication. So for that, this is the XML calling method. So on click, whatever name of the method you want to implement, just give. So here for the multiplication, so call MUL. If you want to implement it by yourself in main Java, then you can. Otherwise, just alt enter, click, yes. Okay, just double click on it. It's automatically prepared the method for you in main activity.java. Clear? This red line was gone out whenever it finds this method in mainActivity.java. Okay, so for division, I'm also creating this method again on click, call division. If you don't want to create automatically, then you have to create this method by coding, but we have option alter enter. Just click on this name and press alter enter. You get the option call division creation. Just double click on it. Automatically, it will create the method. Clear? This is the method creation in Android using the XML bind. Again, by calling the call minus, what we want to perform? We want to perform the minus operation. So again, I am repeating this code. Whenever we want to perform the minus, we need two integer value. Then we need one more variable for storing the answer. So we have already globally defined the variable, that is A, B and answer. So you'll get the idea why I've defined this variable over here. So I can utilize these all variable in all the method. So again, I have to initialize A with whatever value in ed1.getText dot toString, because sometimes it returns the object. So we are converting in string. But here we want to perform mathematical operations. So again, I have to convert this string into the integer. So one method is there. This is integer dot parseInt. In that parseInt, what we have to provide our text which we want to convert. So from where we are getting our text, that is ed1.getText.toString. Again, I am repeating, we have another number we have to store in B equals to, we require the integer, so we must have to pass. So integer dot parse integer method is there, parse integer. In this method, we have to provide the string which we want to parse. So as we know, where is our string? In edx2. So again, ed2 in our Java, we are referring a text number 2 by which object? ed2. So here ed2 dot which method ed2 have? Get text. We want to utilize that text, and that is converted into the integer. Okay, so you are getting we can utilize this text, and now we can perform answer is equals to A minus B. Okay, so my answer is ready. Now I want to display this answer in my this text. Okay, text view. So that text view name is what? Text answer in XML. Whenever I have bind it, I have given the name for text view, that is TV. Okay, by binding which method? Find view by ID, the text answer referred by the TV. Okay, so for sending the text to TV, what I have to use? TV, that is answer dot set text is a method to set the value. So here I have to display the answer. So the answer is just plus and whatever variable name that is your resides in your answer, right? Again, that all tasks we want to perform in multiplication. So this is the similar code, but what I am multiplying it. Okay, this is the multiplication. That's why I'm multiplying it. Again, similar code for division, but just we want to perform the division. So I'm copied that code, just now pasting it and changing the size signed by the division. So automatically these all four operation performed by this one. So again, I'm running it. So you'll get the idea, and we can perform the different formatting task also. So we'll get the better. Okay. Again, it's in processing. This is the existing running.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Meanwhile, can we discuss the query of students?
Yeah, sure. Still, so Malik bhai, we have some formatting.
Okay. Malik bhai, can you allow a second student to talk? Yes.
Yes, yes. Please unmute your mic.
Hi, Katrega. Daniel, you need to unmute yourself. Daniel, in your screen there will be an unmute option.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
You can ask your question. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Ma, I want to know if I'm using for the call. I use lowercase in the XML. Then I decided to change it to an uppercase. Is it?
Yeah. If you want to change the method name, write your question like this. Do you want to change the method name?
Yeah. For the XML, I use lowercase.
Yes.
Yeah, that is lowercase. Okay. Yeah. If you are using lowercase.
Then I decided that, yes, ma'am. Then I decided to use uppercase in the Java. Is it going to give an error?
The error, it gives the runtime exception that is unfortunately closed. Runtime exceptions. And compile time, it will give you error here at a red line. If you are not implementing similar name method in Java, then it will give the error in red line. Okay. And if after running, you will change this name by small c to capital C, then it will give the runtime exceptions. Okay. That's why, again, I am repeating, XML is also case sensitive and Java is also case sensitive. Whatever conventions we have defined over here that we must have to take care in our Java. Because up to which whatever variable you have defined, that method, that similar takes case method, if you are not implementing in Java, then red line will be there. Okay. So after implementing, if you are changing here, then also it gives the runtime exception. So it must require the proper cases for the method naming and all. Okay. So that must be this. Okay. Just see here, our application is already running. Now I am entering the input. Now you can see this is only the integers number. Okay. Because we have defined input type is equals to number. Now I am inserting number 220 in text 1 and number 40 in my text 2. Now I am performing plus, so it will give the 60 as answer, minus, okay, minus, then you will get the minus 20, multiplication, then 100, division, that 0. As you know, why 0? Because that is 20 by 40. Okay, here I want to display my answer in the proper format, that is 20 plus 40 equals to answer. That also we can do. And here just see, whenever we are running in our phone this application, that application already installed in our phone, so we can directly use it from here. Okay, but if we have any updation in this file, in this code, then we must have to run it again. Otherwise, whatever you have updated in your application, that is not in your this application. Clear? So if you have updated something, then you must have to run again. Okay, otherwise you will not get any updating in your APK file. Okay, actually we are running this directly on the phone. So again, just start with formatting of answer. So how we can answer? So we don't want this the answer, we want actual value. So we have what, A and B. So how to format the answer? So for formatting, here I want to display the answer. Okay, similar to our formatting. Now plus is used for the concatenation. So first I want to display the value of A. So here I am writing A. Then plus, what I want to display the plus symbol. So plus, then again I am using plus. What next? A, that means 20 plus 40. So 40 is where? In B. So again, I'm using B. That is my variable. So I don't have to put in quoted whatever predefined text, that is your static text you want to display, then put it in your double quotation and every time use the plus. So just see here, that is the answer, my static text. So I have putted in double quoted. Then plus, I want my variable text, actual value from the A. Then A. This is the concatenation. So whatever value in A, that is 20. So answer colon 20 plus whatever text in B, that is 40, equals to answer. So in answer, we have a 60. So automatically, it gives the formatted answer. So that type of stuff we can do with Android by formatting purpose. So just see here, I'm updating in all my text view, just the sign is different here, minus. I'm copying it and paste it in my four different methods. Okay, here we have multiplication, and in last we have a division. Okay, this is the division. Clear? So what it will do? It will just change the formatting of my answer, and again I am running. Okay, if anyone have up to these any query, just ask, then we'll start another the last, that is how to define the icon and name of application. So so I've got my answer and formatted whatever we have changed in this latest one. So I am giving next, I am giving the value 10. Okay, now plus, just see your answer, 50 plus 10 equals to 60. So you can see this is the formatted answer. Whatever in A, it automatically printed the value B. If I'm putting or clicking on minus, so automatically it performs the minus. If I'm putting on multiplication, so it will do the multiplication, and division, then it will do the division. So this is how we can develop our application. Okay, so this is the name of my application. So already I have discussed the whatever component. Here we are preparing simple calculator by using only the one component. Please give me in chat which component we have utilized over here. Please answer your my question, that is which component we have utilized here for developing the calculator. We have four components: services, broadcast receiver, activity, content provider. Which we have utilized over here? Only the one component we have utilized here. Just give your answer in chat. We have utilized activity only, because activity at user interface. Okay, now I want to change the name of my application as a calculator. So how we can change? So in other languages, the Android has one more configuration file, that is Android manifest. So whenever we are dealing with any of component and application level configuration we want to perform, then we have to use android.manifest file. Clear? This is the configuration file of your application. Now just see here. Here you have a label, my application. But as I have already discussed, this all in Android is deal as a resource. So here resource, how we can go with the resource? So in Android, we have a resource folder, the values, and we have a string.xml. So here we have the name of application. We can also write directly get the name of application here, but Android just follow the all the rules and regulation in the form of resource manipulation. So here the string is also one of the resource. So whenever, just see here, I'm running my application, you'll get here the name, that is my application. Now I want to change that name as a calculator. So just you have to write here. From where? Every Android has what? One configuration file, Android manifest. You can directly write here, or you have that variable string resource is available under the resource value string.xml. So you can directly update here, and whenever you are running, you will get your updated name. Again, I am repeating, if you are changing here anything, then you must have to run your application again. Otherwise, you will not get any update over here in your APK. So again, I am running, you will get the instruction over here. This is the Gradle building, then you will get the installation, and now again it will installing. Just see here, it's a launching the activity. See here. Again, it will refreshing. So just will get here. Okay. So okay. Yes. Just see here. The name of application, that is the calculator. Just see here your icon of your application, that is here. Calculator, just see here. You can also change this application icon by Android manifest file. Here you have round icon. So if you are changing here the name of your icon or by adding any of another image, then you can change the icon also. Okay, so if you want to change icon, then you have to change the icon from here. You have to add your image, then you have to provide the image name. Okay, so this is all about the configuration file. Just see here, whatever component we are using here, we have only the activity. Just see here, the activity is here. Okay, so that registration automatically done. In previous version, we must have to make a registration, but in latest, we are getting over here. So up to this, and now I am concluding. If you have any query, just ask the question. And again, don't take any type of bothering about how you can learn. This is the demonstration. That's why we are directly developing application. But by opting this course, you will learn from the scratch level of application development to the Android application development. Okay, so this is from my side. If you have any question, just ask. You can see here, these are the content of the course, main topic. From the installation, programming, and then you will get the detailed development learning. Okay. If you have any question, you can ask in chat or by raising the hand, you can ask. Hope you will get the idea how the Android application works directly. We can run it in our mobile.
Yes, ma'am. So one of the question which has been raised in the question box is like, so Anita has basically missed the introduction part. I would request you if you could just debrief how we went, how we started from the beginning, and how the entire flow of 2 hours went, and how, why this course is very much beneficial for the students. If there could be just a quick recap of the entire webinar, it will be great.
Okay, sure, ma'am. So yeah. This webinar is just for to give you the insights how you can develop a career as Android developer. So from the starting, we have discussed already the career opportunity, how the Android market take over by globally. So we can get the idea the Android is acceptable 87% globally. So there are lots of opportunity we can opt as becoming an Android developer. So in this course, in this webinar, we have started with the introduction, the version and version history and the feature, and directly we have developed an application. But by opting this course, you will learn from the basic programming fundamentals to how you can develop Android application. So everything you will learn step by step in this 60 hours. And after just opting and entire completion of this course, you will able to develop the simple application, basic applications like your Instagram. The basic application you can build, any form like application, your QR code like application by completion of this course. And as you know, the career opportunity as an Android developer is available in market. And we had already shared the statistics globally. So there are the chances you can build your career as Android developer. Okay, so I hope you'll get the idea.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Let me just cross check with the chat if we are having any other questions. Daniel is raising hand from quite some time, but we even tried to onboard Daniel, but he wasn't able to speak. We can try it once again. Let us give it a try.
Yes.
Daniel, are you able to unmute yourself? If there is some connectivity issue at your end, you can just write it down, your doubt if you are having, you can write it down in the chat box also. I'm sure there's some connectivity issue, ma'am. We'll move forward then. Isa is having one more. Yes. Can we take Isa?
Yes. Malik bhai?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. What is your doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Hmm. In some calculators, we are seeing a button for equals to. I don't know if we can create equals to instead of having an answer for the end users.
Again, please repeat your doubt.
Yes, ma'am. In some calculators we are using, we are seeing equals to sign instead of equals to button.
Yes. Instead of the answer. That you can create by performing or just adding advanced concepts. Like after just doing this course, you can develop calculator. Like by putting on plus, what the actual calculator doing, what it add your number in your screen and in background it performing the calculation. And at last you are performing on equals to. So it will show you the answer. But here for the demonstration, what we are doing, we are taking to value and then plus, and directly it will just display the answer. But after this all, we can add the equals to. So whenever we are adding multiple values, okay, here we have two text box, so we have only the two values. But if we have a single text box and every time we want to add it and we want to display the answer, then we can prepare it by like this. Getting me? This is just for the demonstration, so you'll get the idea. This type of application we can build. Getting me?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, this is just for the demonstration purpose, but you can develop this by adding more code. Okay, so you have to make a concatenations and you have to add in array, then you have to perform the calculations. Single sites, it's not possible at a time. That's why we have created a simple basic calculator.
Okay.
Sorry. Thank you, Isa. Okay. And Daniel was just asking this thing. He had missed the introduction part, but I guess, madam, you have beautifully covered the entire, what is the gist of the entire webinar of today's on basic how to do basic Android level application. That was very beautifully explained. Thank you so much. I would request all the panelists So we are very pretty much open for the question and answer. If there is, I would request all the panelists to please turn on their video. If we could have a snapshot of today's session. And I would request Professor Hiral ma'am to in fact stop sharing her screen also.
Sure. Yeah.
I hope my smile is good enough.
No, yes.
Malik bhai, if you could just take the screenshot.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Hey, Fred, how are you?
Okay, how are you?
Okay, Malik bhai, just let us know if it's done.
Or if he even needs wider smiles, we can as well pull it off.
Where was Christine today?
And ma'am.
Okay. I think she was busy. She had some marketing activity at the university, which was already scheduled, and so we've been working with Noah.
Oh, okay.
Make sure that,
yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing the video. I'll just turn it off. To all the participants, thank you so much for joining the webinar today. And tomorrow, since today you learned the basic level of it, tomorrow we will be taking you to the advanced level of it. So it's very interesting. In fact, I would like everyone to actually share the link across your classmates also. And since we have 8 of attendees have already joined today, right? So 8 of you already know how to join this webinar. It will be really great if you share the same process to everyone so that, you know, we can have more onboarding as well. And we are looking forward. Have a nice day. Thank you so much once again. I would request, so Bill sir, we can do one thing. We can request all the attendees to leave the session. We won't leave any person. The attendees have to leave the session and we can stay in the same recording itself, sir.
Yeah. Yes. All right. Thank you. Let's see how to commit to them.
Yeah. Yes. And I once again request all attendees, thank you so much. And you can leave the meeting. Thank you so much. We'll see you tomorrow at the same time. Bill sir, I'll just take 2 minutes of time. Give me 2 minutes. I'll resume. Yes, sir.
I request all the attendees to press the leave button, which is at the right bottom, so you can leave the meeting. Thank you.